Hello everyone and welcome. In this lesson we are going to talk about the components of medical terms. Let's get started. Medical terms generally derive from the early Greek and Latin languages. Because in ancient times both the Romans and the Greeks advanced the study and practice of medicine. They named anatomical structures, diseases, and treatments in their own languages. These Latin and Greek words remain a part of medical language today. It is also efficient, although some of the terms are long, they often reduce an entire phrase to a single word. The one word gastroduodenostomy, for example, stands for a communication between the stomach and the first part of the small intestine. This word might seem complex, but by splitting it into its components, it will be more familiar. And this is what we are going to learn in this lesson. Medical terms are made up of three word elements: prefixes, roots, and suffixes. But not all terms have all three parts. Let's talk about each component in details and begin with roots. Roots are the element that provide the core meaning of the word. And they usually identify a body part or an action. You can expand a root and change its meaning by adding a prefix before the word or a suffix after the word. Roots appear anywhere in the term. Medical terms have one or more roots, or even not at all. As in the term neoplasm, where neo is a prefix meaning new, and plasm is a suffix meaning growth, and the term means new growth. More than one root can have the same meaning. As the root pneumon, taken from the Greek word meaning lung or air. Also, the root pulmon, taken from the Latin word means lung or air. Because roots are often joined to other elements in a medical term, we add a combining vowel to create a combining form. Such as the letter O to the end of the root, like pneum, to form pneumo. Any vowel like A, B, I, O, or U, can be used as a combining vowel. Like the root respir, means to breathe. Adding the combining vowel A, makes the combining form respira. So, we use combining forms to attach a root to another one, or to another combining form, and before a suffix. An example of a term with more than one root, the word hemopneumothorax, it has the root hem, from the Greek word meaning blood, and the root pneum, from the Greek word meaning air or lung, and the suffix thorax from the Greek word meaning chest. The combining vowel O is added to these two roots to make the combining forms hemo and pneumo. And a combining vowel is used to join the root pneum to the suffix thorax. And hemopneumothorax is the presence of air and blood in the space that surrounds the lungs in the chest. As blood and air fill the pleural cavity, the lungs cannot expand and respiration is not possible, thus forcing the affected lung to collapse. Next, we are going to talk about suffixes. A suffix is added to the end of a medical root or a combining form to modify its meaning and to change its part of speech. And most medical words contain a suffix. Medical suffixes can be organized by their purpose or function, such as diagnostic, surgical, pathologic, and descriptive or adjectival. You don't have to memorize all of these suffixes now. The suffixes will reappear during your study, but we will give you some examples of some suffix classes. For the diagnostic suffixes, when added to a root or combining form, produces a medical term that is a diagnosis or a procedure or test to identify the nature of an illness. For example, the combining form cardio plus the suffix graph, which means an instrument used to record heart activity. And for the surgical suffixes, when added to a root or combining form, they produce medical terms that describe the invasive surgical procedure performed on the body. As in the term appendectomy, the suffix ectomy means surgical removal. And the term means surgical removal of the appendix. And for the pathologic suffixes, when added to a root or combining form, this type of suffix produces a medical term that describes a symptom or sign of a disease process. For example, the term arthralgia. The suffix alga means pain. And the term means pain in a joint or joints. For the adjectival suffixes, there are 28 suffixes that mean pertaining to. These suffixes are used as adjectives to describe the root. An example of adjectival suffixes is the suffix ac, as in the term cardiac, which means pertaining to the heart. Several suffixes do not fall under any of the earlier classifications, but maintain the root or combining form as a noun. These are noun suffixes, like the suffix iatry, which means treatment or medical specialty, as in the term psychiatry, which means diagnosis and treatment of mental disorders. Next, we are going to talk about prefixes. A prefix is a word element attached to the beginning of a root and do not require combining vowels. However, not all medical terms have a prefix. Adding or changing a prefix changes the meaning of the word. Prefixes usually indicate a number, time, position, direction, or negation. And prefixes can be grouped according to their descriptive function. An example of prefixes of position is the prefix ep, which means above, over, or upon, as in the term epidermis, which means the top layer of the skin. And an example of prefixes of number and measurement, the prefix bi, which means two, twice, or double, as in the term bilateral, which means pertaining to or related to two sides of the body. An example of prefixes of direction and location, the prefix ab, which means away from, as in the term abduction, which means action of moving away from the midline. There are another classes of prefixes, but like the other word parts that you have studied, they will appear and reappear during your study. Some medical terms are solid and cannot be broken down into elements. Examples are virus, a Latin word meaning poison, and toxin, a Greek word meaning poison. Though they have the same meaning in their original language, when they are converted to modern medical language, they have very different meanings. These solid words have to be recognized and their meanings memorized. Last thing you should know is that medical terminology also includes eponyms, and an eponym is a word that is created from the name of a person. A medical eponym is created by naming a disease, a test, or another facet of medicine for the person who discovered it, suffered from it, or in some other way contributed to it by way of a legacy. And an example of eponyms is Alzheimer's disease. And to summarize, we agreed that medical terms generally derive from the early Greek and Latin languages. Medical word parts are root and a prefix before the root or a suffix after the root. And because roots are often joined to other elements in a medical term, we add a combining vowel to create a combining form. Combining vowels are a, b, I, o, or u, and used to join a root or a combining form to another or to a suffix. Combining form is root plus combining vowel. A suffix is added to the end of a medical root or a combining form to modify its meaning. A prefix is a word element attached to the beginning of a root. There are some unique medical terms that cannot be broken down into elements, like the term virus. An eponym is a word that is created from the name of a person, like Alzheimer's disease. Next lesson, we are going to talk about rules for analyzing, defining, building, and pronouncing medical terms. See you there.